Hi, my name's Levi. Today I'm going to tell you about the ambitious Henry Ford. Henry Ford by Levi, Shropshire. Who was the man who invented the affordable automobile, gave away millions of dollars, and changed the landscape of America forever? Henry Ford. Henry Ford was quoted as saying, "It has been my observation that most people get ahead during the time that others waste." This was an exceptional truth for his legacy. Born in 1863, just in time for America's booming industrial revolution, Henry was determined to make his life count. He dedicated his life to hard work and his dreams. Even from a young age, he tinkered with machines. In 1903, he established the Ford Motor Company, which led to the assembly line and to the infamous Model T car. With over 15 million Model T cars on the road, the infrastructure of America was changed forever. Not one to hoard his wealth, Ford was dedicated to philanthropy. Can't wait to tell you about the ambitious Henry Ford. Henry Ford's early life was characterized by his love for farming, family, and machines. He was born on July 30th, 1863, in the dead center of the American Civil War. He was born in Greenfield, later known as Dearborn, Michigan. One of six children, Henry was born to William and Mary Ford on their large family farm in a seven-room house. He was stupendous at math and a stinking genius at machines. Although he easily could have worked on his father's farm, he found his interest lied elsewhere. Lovingly, he tinkered incessantly with clocks, watches, and small machines, so much so that his siblings would hide gifts and small machines from him, which if he found, he would promptly take apart. Not only was he adept at farming and mechanical engineering, he was innovative at building. Clearly, even in his early years, machines and family were important to him. Inspired by his incessant love for machines, Ford passionately and zealously pursued his dream. He wanted one thing, the creation of a working automobile that was affordable for all people. In 1894, he built his first working gasoline engine. Working around the clock, in just 2 years, innovation struck again, and Henry introduced the world to the quadricycle. Boasting two forward speeds and no reverse, it was one of the first self-propelled vehicles ever made. Excitedly, Ford hopped in and drove it for a few blocks before it broke down. Ford wasn't discouraged, though he simply said, "The only real mistake is the one from which we learn nothing." In 1901, Ford began racing his automobiles to raise money. His first car, dubbed the 999, set a new world land record at 91.37 miles per hour. Using his hard-earned racing money, Ford turned the profit from his dreams into a reality, establishing a Ford Motor Company in 1903. Creating an affordable car was not an easy endeavor, but soon the Model A rolled out of the factory. While revolutionary, the Model A was a far cry from his quest for a reliable vehicle that was affordable for all. It had two forward speeds and a reverse gear, a top speed of 30 miles per hour, and it cost $850. He could only make $15 a day. However, he was still prosperous, making over $100,000 in profit in the first year. 1908 changed everything. The Model T car had four cylinders, a top speed of 45 miles per hour, and got 20 miles per gallon of gas. This was incredible for its time. The demand was great, and he doubled production every year. Ford's fierce focus led to the assembly line. Previously, each vehicle was assembled in a single location with all the parts being brought right to it. Ford was not the first person to create the internal combustion engine or the assembly line, but he maximized them to their greatest efficiency. Utilizing a rope and pulley, Ford's factory pulled a vehicle on the assembly line while men put the pieces on. Each man only had one job to do, which drastically decreased the amount of time required to build each vehicle. The numbers speak for themselves. The Model T went from taking 12 hours to build to a mere 90 minutes. The cost also reflected, with the price decreasing from $850 to $269. As production continued to increase, Ford needed over 53,000 employees a year to keep his assembly line moving. Due to the repetitive nature of the work, Ford had a hard time keeping workers. To continue business, he shortened the work days from 6 days to 5 days and increased the daily pay to an unprecedented $5 a day. Another major contribution of Ford's was to America's infrastructure. Because of the amount of Ford vehicles on the road, America needed brand new roads, bridges, and even new communities. After changing the face of America's landscape forever by producing over 15 million Model Ts, the Model T sales began to drop due to competitors adding new features that the Model T lacked. In 1928, Ford proudly came to market with the first V8 engine in the remodeled and revamped Model A. After years of hard work, Ford completed its goal of an affordable car for all people. But was there more to Henry Ford than just cars? His life was filled with passion of friends, family, and philanthropy. For Ford's fame, much of the credit goes to his loving wife of 55 years, Clara. Henry met Clara at a New Year's Eve party, and he instantly knew she was the one. After achieving success, Ford built the grand estate named Fairlane. This prominent home audaciously boasted a whopping 56 rooms, and sat on 1,300 acres. He was lifelong friends with both Thomas Edison and Harvey Firestone, the head of Firestone Tire Company. And did you know, guys, that Ford trucks still come with Firestone tires on them today? They took infinitely awesome vacations together several times a year. Although he was a pacifist and against the idea of war, he felt it was imperative to serve his country during wartime. He transformed his factories and assembly lines towards making military equipment. He was making up to 650 bombers per month and many other military vehicles. Ford wasn't successful at everything he tried. He made several airplanes. The most famous had three engines in it, but it never made a profit, and he eventually quit. In an effort to secure rubber for his tires, he even established several cities in the Amazon rainforest to supply rubber for Ford tires. This wasn't a disaster that ended in chaos and riots. However, he successfully started another business selling scrap wood from his Model T factories. The scrap wood was turned into charcoal. The Kingsford Charcoal Company is still in business today. Ford also owned a newspaper. It regularly published anti-Semitic articles. Anti-Semitic is a word that means a hatred of Jewish people. Although he publicly apologized, he was often heard espousing such beliefs. Nonetheless, he did hire immigrants, disabled war veterans, and African Americans decades before the Civil Rights Movement forced other companies to.
You did great.
Without meaning to, Ford became entangled politically and received votes towards presidential nomination. He did not want to be president and declined the position. Notwithstanding, he ran for Senate, but refused to spend even one penny on the campaigning. Even so, he barely lost by only 4,500 votes. Henry and Clara only had one child, a son named Edsel Ford. Henry gave over the Ford Motor Company to Edsel, but never fully trusted him to run it. Edsel passionately tried to prove himself over and over again to his father. Tragically, he worked himself to death due to a stomach ulcer in 1943. His death, 49 years of age, cost the 80-year-old Henry dearly. In 1945, Henry finally turned the company over to his grandson, Henry Ford II. In the last two prominent years of Henry Ford's life, he focused his attention on the Ford Foundation. The Ford Foundation, which is still very active today, is a charitable organization that donates money to schools, museums, science, and much more. You can see there is much more to Henry Ford than just business and automobiles. He genuinely had a love for family, friends, and philanthropy. Like everyone's life, Henry Ford's was filled with hard work, tragedy, and success. However, few people have been as successful as this esteemed dreamer. From his early life playing with farm equipment, to the monumental and extremely profitable Ford Motor Company, Ford's life was worthy of inspection and admiration. Like all people, he had struggles, some of which deeply affected those he loved. However, few could disagree that his life had a major, significant, and deep, profound impact. Henry Ford undoubtedly put the whole world, if not just America, on wheels.